Something else you've been writing and talking about recently is suicidal empathy. Explain to my audience what you mean by that and, again, how that can manifest itself.
Right, yeah, thank you. That's a great question. That's actually the topic of my next book that I'm currently working on. So look, empathy is a noble virtue. Our emotional system has evolved to solve important evolutionary problems. But the problem arises when it misfires. So take, for example, obsessive compulsive disorder, right? Obsessive compulsive disorder is a misfiring of an otherwise adaptive process. For me to wash my hands because I shook the hand of someone that sneezed in his hand makes perfect evolutionary sense. But if I spend the next 8 hours washing my hands, it becomes dysfunctional. So same thing applies for empathy. Within a certain functional zone, to be empathetic makes sense. When it misfires, when it becomes hyperactive, when it targets the wrong individuals, right? When you start caring more about illegal migrants than you do about your own veterans who served in protecting your country, when you care more about homeless people who are doing drugs in the park rather than the children who play in those parks, that's what I call suicidal empathy. When you are so kind-hearted and progressive that you allow millions of people into your country that don't share any of the foundational values that define your host society, that becomes suicidal empathy. So when you take parasitic thinking, the topic of my earlier book, and you couple it with suicidal empathy, you have the perfect cocktail for the end of the West.
Oh, yes, we are in a civilizational war, aren't we? And the anti-West forces seem to be winning. Before you go, you are in Canada. You mentioned your Prime Minister, Justin Trudeau, has been a poster child for the parasitic mind, the woke neo-Marxists. What state is the country in? And have Canadians finally tired of Trudeau's performative caring routine? Have they finally woken up to the fact that he hasn't actually been fantastic for the country?
Well, they seem to have tired of him, and yet they found a way to elect him on three occasions. But I can answer you on a personal level. I'm so tired of him that that's precisely why I've taken this visiting professorship and global ambassadorship at Northwood University in Michigan, precisely because I needed to put a pause button on all the woke craziness that's taking place in Canada.
Well, you've got an election coming up next year, so best of luck. Dr. Gad Saad, thank you so much for your time. Always a pleasure to have you on the program.
Thank you so much. Cheers.